Six on five with the empty net at the other end. Svechnikov, another block shot. Burns in the corner to Jarvis. One-timer, score! Don't tip in, we're tied! Sebastian Aho ties it with 2:15 to go.
And when you don't get the clear, you have the defensive zone draw. And the Canes recognize that. And this is quick touches. Svechnikov, half slapper a la Nikita Kucherov. And it's Sebastian Aho, fishy, as he's officially known to his teammates, on the back door with the chip. This place is pandemonium.
The Canes have rallied from 3-0 down to tie it. Drury enters the zone, plays it in deep for Carolina. Loose, score!
Forecheck, and it's Martinuk with the hit on Dobson. Quick pickpocket, and he slams this one short side. Yeoman's work by Martinuk, a big part of the Canes, is their forecheck. Jordan Martinuk bringing these fans to their highest life here in Raleigh, North Carolina. Wow, 9 seconds apart.
Timeout for the Islanders. And a three-goal third for Carolina. They tie it, and then 9 seconds later, they capture their first lead.
The roof's about to blow off the building. Rod Brind'Amour going to the board. These guys were here in 02, those two guys in the tuxes. They were there in 06 when they won the Stanley Cup. Kaniak showing out. And they've stunned the Islanders, who had this game under full control.
Up 3-1 in the third. And they were doing what they wanted to do in terms of milking the clock, clogging up the middle of the ice. But somehow the Canes got back into this game and have now taken the lead. Do the Islanders have an answer? They have just one shot here in the third period. Mike Riley leaves it for Horvat. Broken up by Martinuk and sent in by Staal. Horvat makes it back for Riley. Eludes Martinuk, who has right now the go-ahead goal. Aho tied it. Martinuk gave him the lead. Here comes Bo Horvat. Heading to the bench is Varlamov. Horvat into the zone. Slavin lost his stick for Carolina. Palmieri down low. Palmieri tries to jam it. Loose in the slot. And a clear for the Canes. Goes to track it down. And nearly a turnover that ends up in the back of the net. 75 seconds to go. Barzal chips it in. Palmieri tries to jump on the puck. The Islanders control. The extra attacker, Horvat, in the corner. Lays it behind. Steered along by Palmieri. At the point, Aho leads it up the wall. Gensel in the zone. Gensel drives it in. Score! Frustration after the goal from the Islanders, but the empty net goal and a 5-3 lead.
Here's another look at that entire sequence, and this is a miscue and a great recovery, though, by Riley. Sebastian Aho barking out orders. Watch the Canes in the neutral zone. They did a really good job And then they get the recovery in their defensive zone, do the Canes get the clear. And this is why you've got to go out and make deals at the trade deadline. And I got to give Tom Dundon and the Canes a lot of credit. The biggest fish on the board at the trade deadline was Jake Guentzel. They went out and got him, point per game player in the Stanley Cup playoffs, and he looms large here in game two.
Three goals in the span of 80 seconds for the Carolina Hurricanes, who have turned a 3-0 deficit, 3-1 in the third, to a 5-3 lead. And we're going to maybe have some penalties coming out of this. I saw Kyle Palmieri sent off to the dressing room.
Yeah, he was trying to muck it up and trying to goad some of the Canes players into the fracas. And to your point, some frustration for sure as a result. Here's another look at that. And Guentzel doesn't do anything that's against the code. But Nelson with the slash, Guentzel right in front of him, gives him a shot of his own. And emphatic response here by the Canes. They've absolutely rescued this game off the mat.
Brock Nelson also sent to the room for the Islanders. So a two-goal lead. And Jake Guentzel now at 60 career Stanley Cup playoff games, 60 points. Chatfield to the line, and a drive that's gloved and held onto by Varlamov. And he holds for a draw with 39.8 to go.
And of course, and you can see that's Clutterbuck in there. The Isles want to muck this up at this point. But cooler heads have to prevail for both teams at this point. You don't want to lose a player to suspension. And we might get a tilt here. It's Nason Martin trying to go after him. Nason hogties him. Martin, one of the toughest customers in the National Hockey League to this day, takes exception.
So some Islanders have been sent off. You saw Bortuzzo heading to the room. And the refs and the linesmen trying to get a hold of this one with 39.8 to go. And Matt Martin's evening is done.
So that'll spell the end of the night for Martin. And we've seen literally everything here in this third period. Nason, who had a spirited tilt with Kyle MacLean earlier in the first. But listen to this great soundtrack. There's nothing, no soundtrack in sports like the Stanley Cup playoffs. Drink it in, folks.
So Stephen Nason sent off. 39.8 to go. And the Canes, from 3-0 down, about to go up 2-0 in this series, with it shifting back to Long Island. And what needs to change for the Islanders heading home?
Gas pedal has to be pushed all the way for the entire 60 or whatever it takes. They took their foot off the pedal. That's exactly what happened last night with Nashville up in beautiful Vancouver and allowed the Canucks to come back. And I told you this early in the game, if the Islanders don't keep the foot on the gas pedal, the Canes have it in them, and they've shown that here.
And they had the opportunity also, Weeksy, to take game one.
Yes.
For 40 minutes, they controlled that game too.
If I'm an Islander fan, I love the way our team's played. Islander fans in Uniondale, Huntington, you name it, they've got to be impressed with the way their team's played here in games one and two on the road. But you got to keep that foot all the way down through the finish line. And a team like the Canes, they smelt those opportunities. They were able to get back. The power play rescued them. This is a comeback of epic proportions here. I'll tell you, we showed you the graphic earlier.
The Islanders had never lost a game when leading by three goals in
ever
the Cup playoff.
In their franchise history in the postseason. And we know how rich that postseason is.
And for the Canes, they hadn't rallied from a three-goal deficit since the Cup final when they beat Edmonton in 06. So a power play, an extended one for Carolina, trying to put the finishing touches on game two and take a 2-0 lead up to New York. Here is Orlov at the blue line, over to Kuznetsov. And that one goes high, hits off the back glass. 15 seconds remain. in front. Jalen Chatfield getting power play time and tries to bulldoze his way into the net. Yeah. And here we go again. And Cizikas, right there on the doorstep for the Islanders, will have no part of this.
Varlamov made two huge stops there. And Jalen Chatfield, another Michigander on the ice here. Michigan native gets involved, and here's another look. And you'll see the first save, point blank by Varlamov. Two, the second one of the glove. Okay, Cizikas pushes him in there, but Chatfield's at the line of scrimmage like he's playing for the Lions.
It's fourth and one.
It's fourth and one. He's trying to break the plane.
And more people are getting sent off.
Oh, yeah.
Cizikas is done. Chatfield heading to the room.
And that's a great job by the officials trying to keep the best they can a lid on the game, as our Dave Jackson always mentions. So they're not taking any chances. They don't want this to bubble over anymore. There's so much natural excitement and emotion in the game, and certainly some frustration at this point. So good job by the officials, I'm sure.
Terrific job by the officiating to get a hold of this game. Don't let it get out of control.
That's right. I'm sure Stephen Walken would love that. Hockey ops department up in Toronto.
And don't let the gong show happen here at the end of the game.
No. Leave that for the WWE.
Final seconds ticking down, and a full four-goal third period for the Canes, and a dramatic comeback for Carolina. They lead the series 2-0. 5-3, they win game two.